Hello, everyone. My name is Ivan Vedrov, Family First Life out of Chicago area. So thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to jump on Facebook Live and learn about such amazing opportunity as Family First Life. So I've been with the company for about 3 years. Just wanted to talk to you guys about how I cross paths with Family First Life, how my journey began, what this opportunity means to me now, and yeah, so let's begin. And I just wanted to say, first of all, honestly, I just want to say thank you to Sean Mike and to everyone who found such an amazing company. So, and whether you are in the insurance industry already or not, I think this will be very useful information to you so you can understand how Family First Life works, what it does, and actually decide for yourself whether it's the right opportunity for you or not, because it's not a right opportunity for everyone, I'm not gonna lie. So, and plus on top of it, we don't even hire anybody. So, but at the end of this video, if you like what you saw, what you heard, just get back to the person that shared this link with you and let them know what you think. So, but as I said, I've been here for about 3 years now. It's been a great journey. Before that, I've done all kinds of things, but my journey began about 10 years ago when I moved to the United States. I've only been here for about 10 years. So, and why am I saying this? Well, I mean, because first of all, I spoke almost no English 10 years ago. Now I do a little bit. So, and I just want to say anybody can do this. When it comes to Family First Life and Family First Life system, anybody can do this, okay? So I've done all kinds of sales jobs before, and prior to insurance, I've done real estate and property management. I've stayed with the company for about 3 years. So I used to live in Maryland. I live in Chicago now, so me and my wife, we were kind of back and forth, trying to find where we want to live and trying to figure out where we want to live, actually. So trying all kinds of business opportunities, self-employment opportunities, all kinds of gigs. Some of them were good, some of them were not so good, but nothing was like life-changing. So life beat us up a little bit, and we decided to settle for regular jobs. And not that we made a decision, it kind of naturally happened. So we decided to move to Chicago for good and found a job with a property management company. You know, did pretty well, worked there for about 3 years. Didn't have to pay rent or mortgage because they provided all that, which was absolutely awesome. Great salary, benefits, you know, bonuses, trips. So we were doing pretty well. My wife worked for another property management company as an accountant. So it wasn't like anything crazy, but definitely was enough to pay the bills, and it was enough for just for two of us. And then my wife got pregnant, and she told me that she probably would stop working soon. And we also decided that where we lived in huge apartment complex, we don't want to raise kids there. We want something of our own. We want to move to possibly even different area, you know, within Chicagoland territories here. So anyways, I started looking around, and also on top of it, one of my clients, one of the people that lived on that property, young guy, worked for a huge insurance company. He kept telling me about the insurance industry ever since I know him. And then before leaving, I probably knew him for about 2 years. And he kept telling me how his brother is very successful, chief of underwriting department in one of the big corporations. And he travels, he goes to football games, and he's saying insurance is a great industry. He's like, I'm in the beginning of my career there, but I feel very, very well, and everything's great. So, and he also mentioned that the sales side of it is crazy too. It can be crazy. So, I listened to him. I started doing some research again. When my wife got pregnant, we decided that my wife should stop working soon, and we need to find another place. I need to find another job, because where I was, again, it was great for the time being, but it was not anything that's going to allow us to have our own house, have, you know, good life and stable life financially. So start looking around, applied for many different positions, mainly in underwriting and insurance. And, you know, I would not be getting really any phone calls back. My resume was out there as well. One company reached out to me saying, "Ivan, come on over for an interview," which I said, "Well, sure, I'm excited, I'll be there." And turned out it's not an in-office position, it's just insurance sales. So they hired me, and essentially I said, "Sure, fine." And they told me how I'm going to be making $100,000 my first year. So I'm like, "Yeah, that sounds really good to me." You know, I went to school, got my license, quit the job, packed the whole entire household, moved to a different place, also rental for the time being. Started working with that insurance company. They trained me for about 2 months before they let me out in the field. You know, and basically when I walked for the first time, the training facility was kind of separate. When I walked for the first time in the dial room where all the agents were dialing the phone where they hosted the meetings, I noticed, and it was right around November, December. Actually, at that point, it was already January of 2017. So, 'cause I'd already been there for 2 month training. So I noticed that the top guy and the leaderboard was still from the previous year, probably did 75,000 of issue paid premium or 80,000, something like that. And I'm like, "Oh, okay, that's great. But if the top guy, the most experienced guy, the most valuable guy to that company did only 80,000. I'm like, how am I gonna make 100,000 plus commission is not even 100%. The commission is, you know, 50% to start. Maybe that guy was at the higher commission, but I'm like, and some bonuses, but I'm like, I don't believe I can even make it happen. And when I approached my manager, by the way, great guy, forever thankful to him for bringing me into and introducing me to the insurance world. I've learned a lot from him. Fortunately, that model wasn't for me, but, you know, how we began is he said, "Ivan, put a list of 100 people together and start reaching out to them," which was a little crazy. So I did reach out to most of the people I knew from the property where I worked at before. A couple people complained shortly to the new property manager and said that I'm bothering them. So they called me saying, "Ivan, you should stop reaching out to them." Was a lot of people I could have helped with insurance, which I did, quite a few of them, but it wasn't working out after I stopped calling them because I was told I could not. So that was my only marketing strategy. Everybody else in the office, you know, just did cold calling, worked existing book of business. A lot of guys were in the business for a long time. So, and, you know, it wasn't working out for me. I started using credit cards, drained my accounts. And about 3-4 months in, probably maybe even 5 months in, I wasn't like giving up. Plus my wife still was pregnant at that time. So she told me I should stay because of the benefits. So, and I knew that I should stay because of the benefits. And I started doing Uber and Lyft on the side to make the ends meet and make sure we pay the bills and we don't get evicted from our apartment. And, you know, right around May of 2017, I heard about Family First Life. I was in the beginning thinking it's too good to be true. So, and I was listening to different testimonials, possibly like this one as well. I was doing my own research because I was already hurt once. My wife was on me saying, "Hey, you probably don't want to be in the insurance, find a real job." I was, you know, very upfront with her and also honest with myself that with really no degree and no real experience anywhere else, I'm like, I don't even know how I can really make money. You know, if I go to the bank or if I work, you know, whatever kind of job I'll find, I didn't feel like I can find anything that's more like $60,000 a year, you know, after taxes, calculating all the expenses. I kept presenting it to my wife saying, "Well, how are we going to survive? How are we going to pay all the bills? And how are we going to get all the things you want? Because I know what you want, and $60,000 not going to get you that. $80,000 not going to get you that. Possibly not even $100,000, you know, going to solve all our problems here." So, and at that point, I also did some real estate on the side, and it was just very overwhelming. So I always had the work ethic. So I always would wake up at 4:30, you know, in the morning, do the Uber, then do insurance, then do real estate, then do Uber again, get home real late, 10, 11 o'clock, 6 days a week. So I never had the problem with the work ethic, so I just had the problem with the vehicle, where I can apply my work ethic and how can I succeed? How can I have an abundance of, you know, money? You know, how can I make sure that my family's taken care of with a baby on the way? So, and my son was born in June of 2017, and that was a little crazy, new life. And, you know, and my wife was really tired of me waking up at 4, waking everybody up, leaving the house. And, you know, actually not the house, one bedroom apartment, to be honest with you. That's why she would hear everything I'm doing. So, I started thinking, you know, the Uber and Lyft, definitely not going to cut it. You know, there's no long term there. Real estate, I always felt like there's limited inventory and I'm capped. And insurance, well, I was thinking, since I already invested 9 months of my life in the insurance industry and I've already learned so much about it, I realized that might be something. Plus, I liked doing that. I liked helping people. So I was passionate about that. It just, I wasn't making money doing that. It was like my hobby job, you know. And what I've decided to do is I decided to take a leap of faith, give Family First Life a chance, give myself another chance, and basically jump on board, which was the best decision I ever made in my life, to be honest with you. So I remember that morning I basically, you know, was driving. Actually, Saturday weekends, Uber was crazy because I was driving crazy hours. So it was Sunday morning, and that was the only day off. I was driving 6 o'clock in the morning back home after long hours, working all day Saturday, showing apartments, selling insurance, driving the car. I was early in the morning. I was driving off. At that point, I was already contracted. You know, it's probably been 2 weeks. I started the contracting process with Family First Life, listening to all kinds of training, day in and day out, between the rides, between my appointments and everything. So 6 o'clock Saturday morning, I remember how I peeled off all kinds of stickers on my car that I had to for the ride share, I had to put there. So I peeled them off, threw them out the window on the interstate on the way home, because I knew I'm contracted and I'm starting Monday. So I took the rest of the weekend off, which was the remaining of Sundays. And Sundays didn't look good to me because I was like a zombie after working 80 plus hours a week. Didn't feel like I'm a good dad too. So that you know, that pushed me to make a decision. I was in the way desperate, you know, so I wanted to make it work. And what I did, I started the following morning. And you know, what I wanted to talk to you guys about today is really not me, but the reason I brought my example here is just to let you know that anybody, truly anybody, can do this. If the guy like me, who only been in this country for 10 years, spoke no English 10 years ago, able to make this opportunity work and have an abundance of money, you can do it as well. So, and don't forget to say thank you to the person that invited you here. Again, opportunity may not be the right one for you, or the timing may not be right, but I know it works. I know it works 100%. So, plus, as I said before, we don't hire everybody. So, but if you're willing to take the challenge on and put your mind to work, put yourself to work, and achieve great levels of success, Family First Life is the company to be. So I want to go over what Family First Life has to offer and why it is such a you know, place that breeds success. There's so many people that make $20,000 plus every single month here. So a lot. And so basically the way I see insurance, and I guess any business for that matter, but we're talking about insurance here. There's a few pieces of the puzzle that you need to put together, you know, in order to have a successful opportunity, something that allows people to succeed. And I've seen too many companies out there, and I was hired, people was trying to hire me all the time since I've been in the insurance industry. And always when I analyze the opportunity, something would be missing, you know. And unless you have all the stuff together, all the pieces of the puzzle together, I believe it's really hard to survive and make a decent living. So, but wanted to talk to you guys about, first of all, about the comp, because there's good news. Family First Life just raised the comp another time. So on the term side, it's up to 145%. Up to 144% on the final expense side. That is unbelievable, mind-blowing. I was probably three times, my commission initially in the insurance industry was three times lower. Any advance was definitely way lower than that. For all of you guys, all of the new people on this call who new to the insurance industry, I'll explain you guys how the comp works. So starting comp in Family First Life is 100%. Okay, it goes up to 145. Just for the ease of calculation, I'm going to use 100%. So if you're going to help the client with a policy for $83 a month, we're going to multiply it by 12 to figure out what the annual premium is. So the annual premium in that case is $1,000. And as an agent, as an independent agent that works through Family First Life, you'll receive $1,000 as your commission for the sale. So if you sell something that's $83 a month. Now, Family First Life has 75% advance, which is really good. You get $750 up front, $250 later in the month 10, 11, and 12. So, and speaking of everything I did before in the insurance industry, paid at 50% with 50% advance, so I'll get $250 out of a $1,000 sale, which is crazy. Here we get $750 up front, $250 later, and it's could not get better than that, I guess. So the main thing for me personally was when I moved from that company to Family First Life was leads, because I was banging my head on the wall. I was trying to figure out, how do I get my next client? You know, how do I cross paths with my next client? You know, what is it that I need to do? And it was not many options. So I was usually asking referrals. It was usually just doing some crazy cold stuff. You know, I was calling the newspapers. I was calling realtors all the time, because I knew, being a realtor myself, I knew that realtors answered the phone all the time. So the way, and the reason they do is because they're waiting for their next client. So, and I was, not a lot of them were happy to hear from me. That's what I did before. I would call realtors off the newspaper and trying to meet with them and offer them insurance. I've sold a couple, but it was a lot of work behind that. So, which make it very, very unpredictable, very, very unpredictable business model. So when it comes to Family First Life, we work with the lead vendors here that do have all kinds of different lead options for us. So that makes it a very predictable opportunity, where the only thing you need to do is you need to get yourself contracted and get the high comp appointment with insurance carrier, get the leads and dial them. That's really all it takes, you know. So leads make our business very much predictable here. So, which I could not be happier about, because that makes it for me, that made a huge difference. So on top of it, Family First Life means Vesta renewals day one. So you're independent and you're being treated as such, where if you work here and eventually you don't no longer work here, we don't keep your renewals. You get them and you keep them, and they're vested from day one. So when it comes to Family First Life training and the system that we have in place, it's unbelievable. So first of all, not a single person will be training you, will be in front of you, whether it's a live event or Facebook Live. You would not be listening to them trying to teach you how to do certain things, whether it's dialing or what to do in the home. By the way, speaking of the training, there's two things. Number one, it's a training about how to be successful in the regard of what exactly I need to do, what are my steps, what do I say, what I don't say. You know, it's the actual hands-on training on what to do, and not like more of a motivational type of deal where you know, you're just saying, well, you just need to basically, you know, you just need to push through. And you know, when somebody motivating you, somebody that never sold insurance ever, you know, somebody that just trying to motivate you, get you out in the field, and that's where it ends. So with FFL, people that train you, they sell themselves, or they just recently sold on a very high level. I'm talking about 30, 40,000 plus. That's number one. Number two, it's the actual training of what exactly you need to do, what exact leads you need to get, how to become successful. So training is amazing, hands down. So I've learned a lot, and I'm a good copycat. That's why I believe I made it in this business. So, and again, the only reason I'm in front of you guys, and again, not trying to be cocky or anything, again, anybody can do this. Last year alone, on my own pen, outside of the team, I've issued 693,000 of simplified issue life insurance premium. So now next thing is no contract. I think this is huge, especially if you're the one that's trying to decide right now, is it Family First Life or somebody else? And you're like, you know, Family First Life sounds good, but I have a friend that works in another company, or whatever the situation might be. Here's the deal. Family First Life has no contract. A lot of other places do, believe me or not. So if you're going to try some other place first, they're going to lock you in the contract. If you want to leave that company, you wouldn't be able to for 6 months. So you're going to have to do Uber, like me, to wait for 6 months until you can start doing insurance again. So, or something else. Now, the thing is, Family First Life has no contract whatsoever. You have direct contract with insurance carriers. No one keeping you hostage here. If you don't like it, if you're not successful here, if you want to move on to your next opportunity, not a problem whatsoever. So try us first. Give us benefit of the doubt, and you're not going to be locked here. Now, on top of everything, on top of all this great stuff like high comp, leads, Vesta renewals, training from top producers, and no contract, producers and managers here get bonuses, okay? Just the cherry on top. Family First Life doesn't have to do it, but they do it anyways, which we appreciate them so much because of that as well. So there's so many different income sources, bonuses being one of them. So it's a producer bonus that producers get every single year. It's the vice president's bonuses that managers get every single month. On top of it, one of our top carriers also pay 8% every 6 months. So what that means that basically that comp goes from 145 to 153. So isn't that crazy? I bet you've never seen that before, but one of our carriers, again, it's 153, not on every product and every carrier, but if you work with that carrier the most, so your comp can be 153%, which sounds amazing to me. But the main thing on top of anything else is that our system is completely duplicatable. So, and that's to speak about different sources of income. So it's not only your personal production, but on top of it later, you're going to get renewals. You're going to get trailing commissions. You're going to get all kinds of bonuses. If you are producer or if you're a builder, you know, if you're building an agency, if you would like to basically create that as well, you know, the possibilities here outside of my personal production. Me personally, I'm also building the business. I'm hiring other agents, and I'm helping them achieve certain level of success, whatever they want to achieve. But in it, we have duplicatable system in place where if you want to do the same thing, it's totally possible. And I know that some companies will see competition in you, and they'll say, no, you could not hire. You could not do absolutely anything. You could not build an agency for 5 years, 2 years, 10 years, whatever the number is. So they just tell you, you can only produce, you know, and because they see competition in you, they think, well, we don't want you to hire all our agents. We want to hire all the agents ourselves, and we want to keep all the overrides. So, but we do have this duplicatable system in place where your manager will help you, you know, do what they do. And you know, you can do it from day one. So again, that's what we got. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, and if you like what you hear, get back to the person that sent you the link. So, and all that to say is that, again, the opportunity not for everyone, but if you are hard worker and if you are willing to learn something new and keep your mind open, you know, this will be a right place for you. So thank you so much for watching. Again, get back to the person that shared this video with you, and I'll see you around. Have a great day.